be able to make a mistake. That's the truth. So the first day of practice, I went out there. Let's fall, of course, with the head coach. And he said, Chuck, this is your team. So he presented me with about 35 kids. And I had a suit of clothes on the field with these kids going to drills that I don't really know what I'm doing. And so I got through the first day. At the time, I lived at the I don't mind it all over, but I went to the library to get a book on football, trying to know what this is all about. That didn't help. So the next day, I'm back on the field, but not in a suit anymore, and doing my best to get some type of organization. I find a thing I know about for them. And with all these kids, I finally got it a little bit organized, and I carried that from there. And we had a pretty fair season, and we only played 4 games and won 3. That wasn't bad. So the next year, I was elevated to the JV coach. And Dan was a great experience for me. We had, I hate to say it, but we had great teams in Tonawanda at the time. What he referred to that one game. Yeah, I remember it well because I was on the Tonawanda pitch in 1954, and North Tonawanda got lucky. Yeah, so anyway, I stayed with the Tonawanda program for about 12 years, and I think we went the last 8 years of the year, so it wasn't bad, without an assistant coach. So I thought, this is enough, this is too tired, and at the end of the season, near the end of the season, I had a heart disease, and I had a very difficult time for the last team, which was going to be up in Oklahoma. And they said, well, there's nobody to take your team. Well, we were on the computer, there was nobody to go with. So the superintendent and the coach, Brooks Hall, sent a taxi to my house, picked me up, drive me to Oklahoma, and I coached the team at Oklahoma, came home, spent about 2 months in the hospital, recovered from this. And I remember the superintendent coming up to me afterwards and said, you know, you've got to take better care of yourself. So I stayed with the program for a little bit more and finally decided to retire. I had enough. And so I was retired for a year. And I thought I was perfectly retired. Then one day I got a phone call from Father Schweitzer. He said, this is Father Short. I didn't know him at all. And he said, I would like to talk to you. And I said, well, what? He said, I would like to talk to you. Would you come down? So I went down there, sat down with Father Short, and he said, we need a football coach. And I said, no, I finished. He said, we really need a football coach. We want it. And I finished. It pays $2,000. I said, I'll take it. The big deal program was great. So, with these guys here, the Tony and Henry, they can't find anybody better than these three guys playing there. They, as far as I'm concerned, we have 3 All-Stars here for North Tonawanda. But But they did close it down, and I said, well, I'm going to work again. So I was. And I was quite content. So George Bennett came over to my house to see me. And I knew George for quite some time, but I thought it was a manual fall. So I came in, sat down at the kitchen table, and we talked a while, and he said, I want you to vote for North Tonawanda. I said, you got it. Then I'm going to vote for North Tonawanda. And he said, yes, I want you to make it. I need to get Tonawanda. He said, I want you to vote for North Tonawanda. I said, you're serious? He said, yes. So I said, okay, I'll take the job. And not knowing how much it would involve, it was something else. But it was a really, really great experience with guys that I enjoyed. So anyway, that was my career as far as coaching is concerned. I truly enjoyed the just being around teenage boys. They were these guys made it played in North Tonawanda in there and tell you what their history. It just makes me feel so good. They had benefited.